I hope you all are fine and doing safe. So, are you all excited to visit the new country that is Canada?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
So, we are going to land soon in Canada, and the pilot for the today's flight is Dr. Nishtha Jain. So, over to you, Dr. Nishtha.
Hello, students. How are you?
Good, ma'am. How are you?
Good.
How are you, ma'am?
I'm fine. Thank you. So, you're ready for the flight today?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So, let's start with the journey. Yes?
Yesterday's flag.
Oh, wow, Aran. Wow, this is lovely. Lovely. Great.
Thank you, ma'am.
Very good, Aran.
Thank you.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening. Okay, bacho, let's start with the journey, okay? So, let's start with Canada's journey today. So, this, as you can see here, this is the flag of Canada. We'll see that later on, okay? So, what is the location of Canada? We'll see that first. Canada is a country in the North America. Okay, Abir wants to say something?
Yeah, my aunt lives there.
Oh, wow. That's great.
Okay. My brother lives in Toronto.
Okay. That's great, Prakar. Yes, Aran?
Ma'am, my bua also stays over there. Vancouver.
Okay. Great. Okay, so Canada is a country in the North America. It's 10 provinces and 3 territories. Extend from the Atlantic to the Pacific. Okay, first we'll see that in the map here. So, it's 10 provinces and 3 territories. They extend from where to where? From the Atlantic here to the Pacific here. That's a large area, isn't it? Yes? Okay. And northward into the Arctic Ocean here. See this. Okay, here is the Arctic Ocean, here is the Pacific Ocean, and here is the Atlantic Ocean. Okay, so this covers 9.98 million square kilometers. It's a huge area, right? Making it the world's second largest country by total area. Okay, its southern and western border with the United States, stretching 8,891 kilometers, is the world's longest binational land border. I know that's a lot of numbers, so we'll see it once again in short. So it is extending from where to where? From Atlantic Ocean to Pacific Ocean and northwards towards the Arctic Ocean. Okay, these three things are clear. It covers an area of how much? 9.98 million square kilometers, making it the world's second largest country. Fine. And what else did we see? So its southern and western border with the United States, stretching 8,891 kilometers, is the world's longest binational land border. Fine. Now, so as we've already seen, 9.985 million square kilometers or kilometer square is the land area of Canada. Okay, now the national flag of Canada. Okay, so this is simply referred to as the Canadian flag, or maybe unofficially you can call it the maple leaf, which consists of a red field with a white square at its center. In the ratio of 1:2:1, in the middle of which is featured a stylized red 11-pointed maple leaf charged in the center. That's a long statement. No problem. We'll cut it short. Okay, so you can see here what is visible here. There is a red field right here, and here is a red field with a white square in the middle. Fine. Now, this is in the ratio of 1:2:1 here. Now, after this, a stylized red 11-pointed maple leaf charged in the center. So this is an 11-pointed maple leaf in the center of the flag. All right. Hi, Rohita. How are you?
Fine, ma'am.
Good, good. Okay, so it is the first flag to have been adopted by both houses of the parliament. So this was the first flag which was adopted by both the houses of the parliament. Fine. And officially proclaimed by the Canadian monarch as the country's official national flag. So both the parliamentary houses adopted it officially, and then it was officially proclaimed as the national flag of Canada. Okay. Then the flag has become the predominant and the most recognizable national symbol of Canada. So wherever you go in Canada, or if you see that in movies or in some videos, you will see this somewhere or the other. You'll see the flag somewhere or the other representing Canada. Okay. Now let's see the history of Canada. So how was it discovered? We'll see that first. When Europeans explored Canada, they found all regions occupied by the native people, whom they called the Indians. Okay, so when it was explored by the Europeans, it was mainly, you know, inhabited by the native people there, who were called the Indians, because the first explorers thought they had reached the East Indies. So what did they think? That they reached the East Indies. So they called those people the Indians. Okay, the native people lived off the land, some by hunting and gathering, others by raising crops. So what were the main occupations there that time of the native people there? Hunting and gathering, and also raising of crops, or you can call it agriculture. Okay. How old is Canada now? The Canada that we know today is a relatively recent construction. It's not very old, you can say. So it's just less than 65 million years old, not more than that. But it is composed of fragments of crust that are as old as 4 billion years. So the crust fragments which it has, they are as old as 4 billion years. Okay. But actually the Canada which we know now is just 65 million years ago. It was born, you can say. It was born just 65 million years ago. Okay.
The time.
Yes.
That the dinosaurs were killed. That time this thing formed.
Yes. Very good, Abir.
Not okay. Necessary to be exactly. It could happen in that any 1 year period.
Yeah. Maybe like near about that. Not exactly. But yeah. Near about. Yeah. I'm so sorry for that. Yeah, so the name Canada likely comes from the Huron-Iroquois word Canada. Okay, so how was it derived? It was derived from the Huron-Iroquois word Canada, which meant a village or a settlement. Okay. So in 1535, two Aboriginal youths, like the natives who lived there, okay, the Aboriginal youths told the French explorer Jacques Cartier about the route to Canada. You have to just, you know, memorize the names here. You don't have to understand much. But what actually happened there? Two Aboriginal youths, they told a French explorer named Jacques Cartier about the route, about the way to reach Canada. Okay? They were actually referring to the village of Stadacona, the site of the present day city of Quebec. So the site of the present day city, Quebec is a beautiful city there in Canada. So there is a site there, the village of Stadacona. Okay, so that is in the present day situated in the city of Quebec. All right. Canada became a country, the Dominion of Canada, in 1867. So when did it officially become a country? The Dominion of Canada in 1867. Before that, what happened? Yes, yes. So before that, the British North America was made up of a few provinces. Okay. Provinces are somewhat like the states in a country. Okay. Somewhat similar to the states. Or you can call it an administrative division. Fine. So, British North America was made up of a few provinces. The vast area of Rupert's Land, which was privately owned by the Hudson's Bay Company, and the Northwestern Territory. So it became a country officially in 1867. Before that, what was it? The British North America was made up of a few provinces, the vast area of Rupert's Land, which was privately owned by the Hudson's Bay Company, and the Northwestern Territory. All right. Now, when is the Independence Day for Canada? When is the Happy Canada Day? It's on 1st July. Okay.
Oh, it just passed a little while.
Yes, it just passed recently. Okay, and what is the capital of Canada? It's Ottawa.
Ottawa.
Yeah, very good. Okay. Which is the largest state in Canada? It is Nunavut. Okay.
Nunavut.
Yes, and the area, what is the area of this place? 2.093 million square kilometers. That's huge again.
Oh my God.
Yes, so it is the largest state, hence proved. So now we'll see the languages of Canada. A multitude of languages are used in Canada. So according to the 2016 census there, English and French are the mother tongues. Yes, are the mother tongues of 56% and 21% of Canadians respectively. So English is spoken more than French there. Okay.
Yes, but the signs are bilingual because of this reason.
Yes, that's true. And in total, 86.2% of Canadians have working knowledge of English, while just 29.8% have a working knowledge of French. So
but
in
I
both
have
ways
knowledge of French.
Oh, that's great, Prakhar. That's great. Now let's see the Canada's government. So Canada is a parliamentary democracy. Its system of government holds that the law is the supreme authority. There is no one above the law there. Okay, it's a parliamentary democracy. Now who owns Canada? Who is the owner of Canada? The Canada is under whom? So the land of Canada is solely owned by Queen Elizabeth II, who is also the head of the state. Okay, so only 9.7% of the total land of Canada is privately owned, while the rest of the land is crown land, which means it is under Queen Elizabeth. Okay. The land is administered on behalf of the crown, that is the Queen Elizabeth, by various of the government of Canada. So just 9.7% of... Hello? Am I audible properly?
Now, yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
I'm so sorry for the distance. Okay, thank you. All right, so out of the total land of Canada, only 9.7% of the land is owned privately and the rest of the land is under Queen Elizabeth II. Okay, so that is the crown land. Now, who is the Prime Minister of Canada? Justin Trudeau. Okay, you have to remember these names, okay? Justin Trudeau is the Prime Minister of Canada. What is the population of Canada? So according to the recent census, the population is 38.27 million. Okay, that's huge, isn't it? Yes, as per the information, maybe there is an update in that, but as far as I know, it's 38.27 million. Even when it's the second largest. Sorry?
I expected it to be a little more owing to its large size.
Yeah, but then I guess more of the land is under, I guess, maybe cultivations or maybe in the constructions and all.
Yeah, there are lots of gardens and greenery areas.
Yes. A lot of lakes. A lot of lakes are there.
Canada has millions of lakes.
Yes, very true, Rohita. It has millions of lakes. Okay, what is this? Yes, please.
Man, who is the PM? Justin?
Trudeau. Trudeau.
Ma'am, the Canada is also called by some people the lake countries, no?
Yes, because there are millions of lakes there in Canada.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you, Aran. All right. So what is the currency of Canada? It's the Canadian dollar. Yes. So if we see the one coin dollar, it is called the loonie. And the 2 coin dollar, okay, or the $2 coin, whatever you call it, it's called the toonie. Isn't this funny? Yes. The $1 coin is called loonie and $2 coin is called toonie.
Loonie toonie.
Yeah, loonie toonie. Okay, now the national sport. Yes, very good. Yes, you and I got
and they're so that. Funny.
Even India's national sport.
They're so funny.
Yeah, who's speaking? I couldn't hear you. Sudarshan, who spoke right now? Who?
Prakhar.
Their names are so funny.
Yes, the names are so funny. Who's saying this? I can't make it out.
Sudarshan is saying this.
Sudarshan is saying this. Okay, yes, Sudarshan, the names are really funny. Looney Toonie. Okay. So now, the national sports. The game commonly known as ice hockey is recognized as the national winter sport of Canada. So there are two national sports there, winter sports and summer sports. So the winter national sport is ice hockey and the summer national sport is lacrosse. Fine, the game commonly known as lacrosse is hereby recognized and declared to be the national summer sport of Canada. Okay, so there are two national games here.
Yeah, lacrosse is really fun.
Sorry?
It's a pretty fun but commonly unknown sport.
Which one? Lacrosse, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, now let's come to the climate of Canada. So as you all must be knowing, it's very cold there. Yeah, extremely cold.
It's mainly
cold.
A winter region, but the springs are pretty beautiful.
Yes, of course, it has to be. The northern part of Canada is extremely cold, okay? But because why is extremely cold? Because the summer lasts only for 2 months there, okay? But almost all the Canadians live near the southern border and not near the northern border because it's extremely cold there. Fine, where the weather is warmer. So where is the weather warmer in Canada? Towards the southern border.
Yeah, southern border.
Yes. So the climate around Vancouver on Canada's west coast is rainy. Okay? So northern is the extremely cold climate. Southern is a bit warmer. Now on the west coast is what? It's rainy and temperate. So there is less snowy there. Okay? It rarely snows except for the mountains.
Aman, Canada is largely inhabited.
Yes, largely inhabited. Very good. Okay, now the animals time. So animals you will find in Canada. Which are the animals there? The grizzly bear, the cougar, then the moose, the gray wolf, giant Canadian goose, whales, marmot.
I love whales.
Who loves whales?
Abir.
Abir loves whales. And I also know Abir loves to, you know about animals. Isn't it, Abir?
A lot.
Yes, yes, yes. Okay, so the next one is marmot.
I love the moose and the crane.
Who's speaking? Please tell me your name, beta, before speaking. I can't
it's
make
Sudarshan.
It out. Sudarshan, yes, thanks, Prakhar. Yes, Sudarshan.
I love the moose and the goose.
Okay, the moose and the goose, all right. Then next one is Wolverine. Everyone knows Wolverine, isn't it? Yes,
it's an
everyone
animal.
Is aware. Yes.
It's actually the largest member of the weasel family.
Oh, wow. Thanks for the update. And the American pika and bison. So there are these 10 animals you will find commonly in Canada. Yes?
Mom, bison is North America's largest land animal.
All right. Okay. Who said that? Why are you not telling me your names, Vachcho? Tell me your names before speaking. Oh, I am not used to you. Yes, Rohita. All right, Rohita. Thank you. Okay, so Manbir ma'am will play a video for you, a beautiful video. Manbir, over to you.
If anyone is lagging, then they can use the link also.
Yes, of course. Beautiful video. Yes, wasn't it a beautiful video? All snow covered. And yes, yes, it was.
Thank you, Sandeep.
Okay, all right. Yeah. So now let's come to the airline part. Okay, so airline industry in Canada. So Air Canada is the flag carrier and the largest airline of Canada. So which is the largest airline of Canada? Air Canada.
Air Canada.
Okay. Why is it the largest airline? On which basis? By its
by the number of passengers size. And the fleet size.
Yes. So what is the fleet size? The number of planes.
Number of planes they have.
Yes, the planes and aircraft it has. So Air Canada is the largest airline there. It is headquartered in the borough of St. Laurent in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. You have to remember this. Where is it headquartered? In the borough of St. Laurent in Montreal, Quebec, Canada.
I know one part of St. Laurent.
Yeah, what do you know about it?
I know the St. Laurent River.
Oh, wow. Awesome. Okay, students. So, here we come to the end of this Canada trip. Over to Manbir.
So, guys, did you all enjoy it?
Yes, ma'am.
All right.
Yes, ma'am.
So, guys, we'll... yes?
What country are we visiting tomorrow?
We are visiting France on Monday. So Saturday, Sunday, you can take rest, and on Monday we will visit France.
France.
Yes. Cool. So I have a small task for you all.
Yes, ma'am.
So you all have to come up with some interesting facts of France.
Okie dokie, no problem.
Yeah.
One interesting fact I want to share with you all, kids, about Canada. Is, you know, it's the world's most educated country. Are you aware of that?
Yes, ma'am. That's why people
not
prefer going to Canada for jobs.
Yes, it has 99% literacy rate. Canada has 99% literacy rate, and it is the world's most educated country.
Yes, ma'am.
Remember this.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, and there is very hard work to have a job in Canada.
Yeah, it's not easy to have a job there. Very true, very true.
Schooling All is pretty right, good in Canada.
Hello.
What is pretty good?
The schooling.
Yes, of course, the education there is very, very good, of course. That's why there is 99% literacy rate. That's awesome. Okay, so kids, let's end the session now. Yes, Manbir?
Okay, so we'll meet you on Monday. Till then, take care. Bye.
Bye everyone. Bye. Take care.
Thank
Bye,
you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Have a nice day, ma'am.
Thank you. You too.
Bye, ma'am.